Did you know that dwarf runners are trained in the same way as city watchdogs?
No.
Yeah. The coach hides a pint of beer somewhere inside a warehouse. And all the players on the team are then sent to find it. The first one to the beer is named Runner. That's it. The ball's in play. There's gonna be trouble. If insults had any effect on the trajectory of the ball, I guarantee that the dwarfs would be world champions.
This player has opened the slapping box and gives rather generously. Was really strong. Do you think they have some troll blood in them?
Could be. Or maybe his opponent shouldn't speak that way about the family. Ouch! Have a nice sleep.
Little baby gets his medicine and he's having a little nap. But whether he survives that injury or not, the team's insurance premium will be rocketing.
That reminds me of when I took Griff to bits in the 91 final against Whiteland.
Oh, yeah. You kneecapped him.
Nihikara City Chiefs. Netter Ketet Bagar Bandits, just to name a few good Khemri teams. What's your thought on their performances?
Well, Bob, I am not convinced they have risen to their former glory. I think they were better in the old days.
It must be hard to be a Blood Bowl player raised from a long, long sleep. But I have to say, I'm impressed they remember the rules.
Apparently, not all of them remember the game so well, Bob. Thank you. Wizards have not always been able to cast spells safely from behind the sidelines. Why are you playing at the time in an Albion League, a second division that prohibited spellcasting from off the pitch?
Oh, yes. They were great times. I remember fans traveling to games just to see how well Wizards stood up to the mad charge of a raving Blood Bowl star. The noise created by a sizzling fireball, followed by the characteristic sound of the snapping of a wizard's neck. Blood Bowl annals are littered with the stories of teams gone bust with crippling debts.
And with the cost of doping and bribery on the rise, the problem won't be going away.
Every now and again, Blood Bowl throws up a real mixed bag of a team.
Like the Motley Horde that's made up of a bunch of misfits.
Yeah, can't be easy to coach those cast-offs every day of the week.
That lets his biceps do the talking.
Yeah, but from his opponent's point of view, it was a short conversation.
Thank you.
There was a time when the Colleges of Magic hadn't yet ruled on limiting wizard assistance to teams.
Who could forget the infamous 2472 Quagmire incident, when rampant spellcasting caused the entire Bright Crusader Stadium to sink into the earth?
Nobody could forget that. People were blinded for miles around the stadium. Poetry in motion.
What we'd like to see...
more often.
According to the Spike magazine, Kemrian historians and psychiatrists make up a large chunk of the fan base for the Kemrian teams, Bob.
Yes, Jim. Apparently, amnesia psychiatrists are particularly fascinating with the Walatap scavengers, because the only thing they remember are the basic rules of Blood Bowl.
Ha! Oh, yeah! Do you remember that interview we did with them once? The only thing they said was,
We must score touchdowns!
Boom! In the face! And then followed by a clean uppercut! Well done!
Look over there! Some cute little elf beauties are selling Big Moot sandwiches in the stands.
Hey, I'm off to get one. I'll be back in 5 minutes.
And so now you like Big Moot sandwiches?
Yeah, no way! A little elf beauty, yeah.
One that won't be coming back in a hurry. Well, that'll keep him quiet for a while.
Yeah, he's just stuck. Not dead. The Troll Slayers. You know that their first appearance dates back to 2465 in a match between the Giants and Lowdown Rats.
No, I didn't. You know, me and the dwarves, I...
A blitzer called Stout Iron Fist was given the task of protecting the king's son. However, the rats managed to blind Stout. And by the time he was able to clear his eyes, the king's son had been killed by the rat's troll. Stout, of course, flew into a frenzy and decapitated the troll.
Ouch. Poor troll. Yes! It's a great spectacle, Bob! Blood Bowl is reputedly the toughest of all sports.
So they say. But it really only comes down to taking a few hits.
Today's insight comes from Jaime Schnibble, coach and owner of the Goblin Lowdown Rats team. In yesterday's Spike magazine, he said that Blood Bowl was like war. No winners, just survivors.
Oh, that's deep. About as deep as his team's position in the rankings.
Nice left punch. Right on the nose.
Sure was, Jim. It's broken now.
Thank you. don't see much of the Heroes of Lore these days.
I don't know.
For any spectators who aren't aware, the Heroes of Lore hope to show the world a better way by honest, strategic play on the pitch.
It's probably a good thing we don't see them. Did you know that the Pescatits Blackhawks were the first Temri team that took to the pitch again, Jim?
Oh, really, Bob? What woke them up?
It was the magical energy from the Cablevision network. Ball flies through the air?
Right on target. As soon as he throws his first punch,
we know the opponent will be out for lunch. Corruption so widespread that the Referees Guild has set up rules concerning where, when, and how one can accept a bribe.
Under an agreement signed last season, the clubs are not allowed to offer less than the going rate. Like there was some bad blood between those two, eh, Bob?
Yeah, Jim. Something to do with swapped body parts.
Well, that's one with a good reason to go see the apothecary.
Yep, looks like he's gonna need a good one.
That face job is a lot cheaper than a plastic surgeon.
I don't know if he planned it, but it won't do him any harm in the looks department.
He's got the ball! What regulation clobbering!
Doping is really endemic in this sport.
Isn't it written into the game rules? Delivery is within stats reach. Seems this player does all the talking with the fist.
And they clearly know how to get heard.
Check that move.
Made him look stupid to me. Years of training have gone into that standing action.
As they say, practice makes perfect.
You think the players heard the whistle at the end of the first half?
All except the ones who had their ears ripped off.
And halftime interval comes to a close.
And the players trot back onto the pitch after a well-deserved vitamin cocktail. The referees' guild has decided to hire a bodyguard for each game.
Another brilliant idea. And just how effective will one bodyguard be against a stadium full of supporters?
True. Could be a bit one-sided.
Charge!
Don't hit me, don't hit me.
Oops, I'm sorry. That's an old reflex on hearing the starting whistle.
Did you hear about the evil Gits? The team that is made up of the mix of evil players?
Their fans won the Most Evil Supporters of the Year award. Fully merited from what I've seen. Brilliant sidekick to the face. Let's see that again in slow motion. Ouch! He's knocked him senseless.
You're assuming then that he had something between his ears to begin with. You can't say much about that.
Full-blooded, but perfectly legal.
Underworld judges woke up a century prior to the other Khemri teams.
Yes, Jim. Which explains why they are the worst Khemri team out there in the circuit today.
The worst indeed, Bob.
That's right, Jim. They had no one to practice with. That's what happens when a pro crosses an amateur.
Yes, splotch. I don't know if he really liked that uppercut.
He may not have liked it, but he certainly ate it. I've heard of teams that have simply disappeared after being abandoned by their supporters.
Let's say that some teams who haven't won a match for several years have been tied up by their fans and thrown into rubbish containers.
It's the only way to end a downward spiral.
And then pow, right in the face.
Knocked his teeth down his throat.
Yes, Jim. That's never a nice sight. Incoming!
Well, it is a violent sport. Just look at the fans. They're red hot. A majority of supporters reckon that the league should take measures to prevent the small minority of peaceful fans from watching a match from the terraces.
They've got a point. If they don't want to join in the fun, they might as well stay home and watch it on cablevision.
Was worthy of a black orc.
You're telling me it'll take a while to get over it. physical as this, the player is really in the right place.
Exactly. It's really ugly. Sometimes I think they were better off left buried in the sand, Bob.
Really, Jim?
Yeah, Bob. Have you ever actually seen a throw rock or a long bomb?
No, Jim, but I thought you didn't like the throwing game anyway, huh?
He sent him down for a chat with the Astro Granite.
I think she's singing him a lullaby. Missed! The ball bounced everywhere.
I was told that you can find round balls. Much less fun.
Well, the Dwarfs have an excellent approach to a match. As they always say, seek out fear to overcome it, fatigue to go beyond it, adversity to conquer it.
And of all, it's got nothing better to do. The other guy couldn't dodge that one. A recent medical report stated that cerebral hemorrhages were less frequent in Blood Bowl players. Amazing, when you come to think of it.
Not really, when you consider that brains are also less frequent. You can't say much about that.
Full-blooded, but perfectly legal. Oh, no, another one who actually plays the ball.
Nice left punch, right on the nose.
Sure was, Jim. It's broken now. That's what happens when a pro crosses an amateur.
Yes, splotch. Wizards have not always been able to cast spells safely from behind the sidelines. Were you playing at the time in an Albion League, a second division that prohibited spellcasting from off the pitch?
Oh, yes. They were great times. I remember fans traveling to games just to see how well Wizards stood up to the mad charge of a raving Blood Bowl star. The noise created by a sizzling fireball, followed by the characteristic sound of the snapping of a wizard's neck.
His job is a lot cheaper than a plastic surgeon.
I don't know if he planned it, but it won't do him any harm in the looks department.
Nihikara City Chiefs, Neterketet Bagar Bandits, just to name a few good Khemri teams. What's your thought on their performances?
Well, Bob, I am not convinced they have risen to their former glory. I think they were better in the old days.
It must be hard to be a Blood Bowl player raised from a long, long sleep. But I have to say, I'm impressed they remember the rules.
Apparently, not all of them remember the game so well, Bob.
One with a good reason to go see the apothecary.
Yep, looks like he's gonna need a good one.
Blood Bowl is reputedly the toughest of all sports.
So they say. But it really only comes down to taking a few hits.
Children, don't try and do this at home. Remember, these are seasoned professionals.
Well, one of them is anyway. What violence!
Yes, it's a great spectacle, Bob.
In motion.
What we'd like to see
more often. really endemic in this sport.
Isn't it written into the game rules? It seems this player does all the talking with the fists.
And they clearly know how to get heard.
Ouch! That punch knocked his teeth down his throat.
Yes, dear man, that's never a nice sight. Skywards, and the match is on.
He sent him down for a chat with the Astro Granite. Did you hear about the Evil Gits? The team that is made up of the mix of evil players?
Their fans won the Most Evil Supporters of the Year award. Fully merited from what I've seen. Oh no, just look at that!
You'd think that it was the first time he tried to pick up a ball!
Ain't that the truth? In his hands. It's a great pass.
That right hook was worthy of a black orc.
You're telling me it'll take a while to get over it. In a game as physical as this, the player is really in the right place.
Exactly. It's really ugly.
A recent medical report stated that cerebral hemorrhages were less frequent in Blood Bowl players. Amazing, when you come to think of it.
Not really, when you consider that brains are also less frequent.
Boom!